Hello friends, and welcome to AK Agrawal Aptitude Series. Friends, in this session we are going to learn a technique for solving a problem on line graph. Here a line graph is given, and based on this we have to answer certain question. The given information is ratio of pass to fail students of a college are given in the graph. This is the ratio pass to fail students in 2005. This is the 2006, 7, 8 and 9. This is the information given. Based on this information you have to answer certain question. The first question in this series is, if number of fail students in 2006 are 40, how many students pass in that year? In 2006 total 40 students failed. So how many students pass in 2006? This is the answer. This is the question. So just to answer this question, we know pass to fail student in 2006 ratio is 1.7. In 2006 pass to fail students ratio is 1.7. So pass is equal to 1.7 into fail using this equation. Now number of fail students are 40 in 2006. So pass students is equal to 1.7 into 40 is equal to 68 answer. So in 2006 total 68 students pass and 40 students fail. Now using the same graph, let us answer the another question. If number of students every year in the college are 189, how many students failed during these 5 years? There are 5 years data, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Every year some students are failed, some students are passed. Total 189 students are admitted every year. So in these 5 years how many students failed? Okay, it means 189 means pass plus fail is equal to 189 every year, whether it is 2005 or 2009. Every year it will remain constant. Pass plus fail is equal to 189. Some students will pass, some students will fail, because he is asking in 5 years how many students fail. Now let us prepare a small table. Year 2005, 6, 7, 8 and 9 as it is given in the graph, and ratio pass to fail P upon F 1.1, 1.7, 0.42 and 0.75. This is the ratio. So here this ratio means P upon F is equal to 1.1, means P is equal to 1.1 F, P is equal to 1.7 F, P is equal to 0.4 F, P is equal to 2 F, P is equal to 0.7 F. Now using this equation and this equation, now we are having one equation, P plus F is equal to 189 and P is equal to 1.1 F. so if we put 1.1 F in this equation, we will get value of F, or number of fail student in 2005. So put P is equal to, in this equation you will get value of F, and once you are having value of F using this or this equation, you can determine value of P. So number of fail students 90 and 99 using this equation and this equation. For 2006 use this equation and this equation, you will get fail students 70 and pass students 119. In 2007 use this equation, P is equal to 0.4 F and P plus F is equal to 189. The number of fail students are 135 and pass students 54. Now P is equal to 2F, F is equal to 63 and P is equal to 126, and using last equation F is 108 and P is 81. So every year these are the number of fail students and these are the number of pass students. You simply add these number of fail students and pass students. Total number of fail students during these 5 years are 466. So answer is A, 466. So during these 5 years total 466 students failed and 479 students passed during these 5 years. Friends, thank you very much for watching this video. You can follow me on Facebook also.